There's no safe iceberg to be close to. They can turn, break, implode in a second with no warning.
It's a sense of awe, it's a sense of fear.
It's kind of like an asteroid or a meteor that we see coming towards us. We have a temperate climate, but we have an Arctic ocean. And we have these Arctic visitors, which are seemingly so far out of place.
You can just look out your kitchen window and see an iceberg. We're that lucky here.
Icebergs are typically found in the world's most remote, coldest, and dangerous seas. But each spring, along Newfoundland's northeast coast, thanks to one singular geological phenomenon, something remarkable happens. Hundreds of icebergs collide with everyday life. What are these icebergs doing here, and why is it imperative that we keep our eyes on them?
There's something about cresting a hill or coming around a corner and all of a sudden realizing that there's an iceberg in the community that is twice as tall as the church.
So that'd be about a medium to small iceberg. That's a large one out there.
The past 2 years, we've had very few icebergs, and this year it has been wild. Our icebergs come from Greenland, takes them 2 to 3 years to get here. And the path has become known as Iceberg Alley.
What is Iceberg Alley? It is a pretty narrow lane that icebergs come barreling down the coast seasonally here in Newfoundland and Labrador. And these are big buffalo. They might well average 500,000 tons each. Icebergs are an artifact of continental glaciation. Glaciers creep their way towards the waterline to the ocean, and large chunks of ice break off. We could go out and find an iceberg that is from ice that's 10,000 years old.
Well, there's a lot of life associated with these icebergs. There's a lot of krill that's generated from sea ice and icebergs. There will be a lot of fish that gather around icebergs.
Icebergs in the spring bring us seals and many more polar bears, because polar bears travel on the ice after the seals.
You get waterfowl as well, and I know in particular, sometimes you get snowy owls on them, because they'll follow with the sea ice, and they'll basically make the icebergs their home.
Icebergs can be dangerous in a number of ways. Historically, we know that over 100 years ago, the Titanic sank off Newfoundland, southeast of St. John's, so that iceberg made the full circuit from Greenland around Iceberg Alley and all the way down.
That incident precipitated the creation of the International Ice Patrol. Each year, a specially equipped Hercules aircraft flies out and does a lawnmower-type pattern of surveillance to determine what is the boundary for safe passage.
Icebergs damage nets, they destroy fishing gear. I started off doing whale watching tours. Now the industry has changed completely. Icebergs are a prominent feature of our tourism industry.
We're getting ready to go. We're gonna get everybody to load onto the boats. We'll go down this ladder right here for posterity's sake.
And what particularly holds icebergs in this area? There's a lot of deep water channels with shallow shelves. They're 9/10 below the surface, 1/10 above. And once they get in there, if the currents don't change, they're basically locked in position. Each one is unique. They're all different sizes.
Tabular iceberg is like a table. It's flat. There are pinnacle icebergs that are pointed like cathedrals and things like that. The rounded ones are often shaped by the waves because they've had water wash over them.
Most beautiful, I think, perhaps a dry dock type iceberg, as its name would imply, has almost a shallower area, like a bowl.
You can see in the center there, this would be called a pinnacled iceberg. It has a nice peak on it.
It is also a dry dock. You can see that some parts have broken off. Get some huge chunks of ice over here.
One of the things that becomes more evident when bergs get close is just how different the ice appears to be. The glistening ice surface with water melting on it just makes it look almost artificial or plastic.
I'd say we're just going to go past the debris field. This all foundered from underneath, actually. So I had to be really careful with the ice chunks.
It's like an ocean full of seltzer. The bubbles that are in the ice are really trapped air from the successive snowfall before the industrial age.
Newfoundlanders like to collect clean iceberg ice from the ocean with a dip net. They'll scoop it up and they enjoy it in a cold drink.
No, I can't imagine Newfoundland without icebergs. It's as a part of Newfoundland as our whales and our sea life, the good and the bad.
It's kind of like an artist's painting that's just transient in time, something that gets wiped out after a week, it's gone. And it'll never be back exactly the same.
I've said icebergs are my crystals. They give me energy. They can totally change a mood for me. I'm that passionate about icebergs that an iceberg can make me cry. I think it's the most beautiful thing. Everyone has things that they love, and for me, it's icebergs.